Today's presentation is on escalators and ramps in construction technology module 5. In the overview we have escalators, the design and layout consideration, components, types of escalators, advantages and disadvantages, comparison between elevators and escalators, and finally ramps. The first one being escalator. So escalators, we are all familiar with escalators, and it is a moving staircase or a conveyor transport device for carrying people between floors of a building. The device consists of a motor driven chain of individual linked steps that move up or down on tracks, allowing the step treads to remain horizontal. Escalators have continuous operation without the need of operators. They are in the form of an inclined bridge spanning between the floors. The moving staircase moves up or down, keeping each step horizontal for the passenger. They are used around the world to move pedestrian traffic in places where elevators would be impractical. And the principal areas of usage include department stores, shopping malls, airports, transit system, convention centers, etc., and also public buildings. So they facilitate a high volume of people to descend or ascend one level of vertical travel at low speed. Moving on to the design and layout consideration. The code of practice for installation and maintenance of escalators is IS, that is Indian Standards 4591-1968. Escalators, like moving walkways, are often powered by constant speed, alternating current motors, and move at approximately 1 to 2 feet per second. The typical angle of inclination of an escalator to horizontal floor level is 30 degrees, with a standard rise up to about 60 feet. For normal peak periods, recommended handling capacities is around 3,200 to 6,400 persons per hour, depending upon the width of escalator. They are generally arranged in pairs, and arrangement can be either parallel or crisscross. Modern escalators have single-piece aluminium or stainless steel steps that move on a system of tracks in a continuous loop. A number of factors affect escalator design, which includes physical requirements, location, traffic patterns, safety consideration, and aesthetic preferences. Foremost, physical factors like vertical and horizontal distance to be spanned must be considered. Next, the components of escalators. First, we have the landing platform. These two platforms house the curved sections of tracks as well as the gears and motors that drive the stairs. The top platform contains the motor assembly and the main drive gear, while the bottom holds the steps, return idler sprockets. Next, we have the floor plate. It provides a place for the passengers to stand before they step onto the moving stairs. This plate is flush with the finished floor and is either hinged or removable to allow easily access to the machinery below. Truss. Truss is a hollow metal structure that bridges the lower and upper landings. It is composed of two side sections joined together with cross braces across the bottom and just below the top. The ends of the truss are attached to the top and bottom landing platforms via steel or concrete supports. And this carries all the straight track. Next, we have the steps. They are solid one-piece die-cast aluminium or steel. They are linked by a continuous metal chain that forms a closed loop. The front and back edges of steps are each connected to two wheels. and these are basically moving platform on which escalator passengers ride. We have the handrail. It provides a convenient handhold for passengers while they are riding the escalator. The handrail is pulled along its track by a chain that is connected to the main drive gear by a series of pulleys. The deck board. They are used for preventing clothing from getting caught and other such problems. And we have balustrade, the side of escalator extending above the steps, which includes skirt guard, interior panel, deck board and moving handrails. So that's regarding the various components. Now we can move on to the types of escalators. Basically there are three types, the first one being parallel, and you can see the figure here. These type of escalators go up and down simultaneously. Speed is 0.5 meter per second, inclination 30 degree, 35 degree. The handrails are made of rubber or stainless steel. Steps are made of stainless steel and landing plate with anti-skid stainless steel. Next we have the multi-parallel, the speed being 0.5 meter per second, inclination 30 to 35 degree. Handrails are made of rubber or stainless steel, the step with stainless steel and landing plate with anti-skid stainless steel. Finally, we have the spiral type escalators. Basically, they are used to enhance the architectural beauty and to save the space. The inclined angle is 30 degree, speed is 25 meter per second, number of persons 6,300 per hour, rated speed is 25 meter per minute, and the vertical rise in meters being 3,500 to 6,600. Moving on to the advantages, so it helps a large number of people in moving from one place to another at the same time, and they reduce the need of elevator because people do not have to wait for elevator, and escalator can carry a large number of people at the same time. So compared to elevators, escalators have this advantage. It is helpful for the people that have pain in their legs and joints, that is, it provides comfort. They are effective when used as a mean of guidance and circulation. The speed can be adjusted, which is helpful in managing the crowd. And when turned off, they can be used as a staircase also. Some disadvantages of escalators are that waste of energy when they are not in use and possible injuries when stopped suddenly. So compared to the advantages, these have very little disadvantages. Now moving on to comparison between lift, that is elevators, and escalators. So elevators, we know they are closed cabins inside the vertical shaft. But escalators are moving staircases that allow people to move between the floors in busy places. Lift are fast and can move up or down at great speeds, but escalators are slow moving. Lift move up or down using counterweights or traction cables, but escalator steps are fixed and linked together and move up but come down from behind on a conveyor belt that is driven by a motor. For elevators, less space is used for the construction, while the space used is same as the staircase and connects two floors in the case of escalators. So these are the basic differences between lift and escalators. Moving on to the last one, that is ramp. Ramp is a sloping surface connecting the floors at different levels. It is provided to facilitate physically challenged people or patients to move from one floor to another. Usually provided in places like railway stations, hospitals, etc., where large people or materials move from one floor to other. It is required in multi-story parking facilities also. The code of practice for construction being IS 4963-1987. Slope should be not be more than 1 in 15. It may be of different types, can be straight, dogleg, zigzag or curved. Handrails are to be provided, the height being 0.8 meter. Surface should be non-slippery. The edge finishing to be done. The optimum edge protection of ramp should be minimum 4 inches. And for the ramps, landing should be provided and the minimum length is 1.5 meters. Thank you.